face each other, look deep into each other's eyes.
Oh, Jesus. You don't look like a buck.
Wait, can I do this in the garage?
Can you hold antlers on her head? Your dad has it set out there.
It looks like a million bucks.
Aww, I'm gonna interrupt this marriage for hunting season.
I better be serious or I'm dead.
Yep, you are.
We're here this evening because of the ongoing miracle of love that God has given all humanity. The bounds here in the Chase family, specifically in the lives and the marriage of Curtis and Kelly. Sacrificial love of Christ has given us the example of love for husband and wife. Alicia, Devin, and Thomas have invited us to celebrate with Curtis and Kelly as they renew the covenant of marriage they entered into 25 years ago. Family and friends, will all of you, by God's grace, do everything in your power to uphold and care for the life that Kelly and Curtis share together in the years to come? If so, say we will.
We will.
All right, let's pray. Most gracious and glorious God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you are the eternal creator and preserver of all life. You, Lord, are the author of salvation and the giver of all grace. Renew your blessing upon Curtis and Kelly as they come now to renew the vows that they made before you 25 years ago. Grant that their vows to one another remain in the strength of your steadfast love. Empower them to continue to grow in love and peace with each other, and especially with you throughout their days. Open the doors that will allow them to build your kingdom as they reach out in concern and service to the world. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 through 6.
Wait, no. We didn't read.
As a prisoner for the Lord, then, I urge you to live a life worthy of the calling you've received. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. There's one body, one Spirit, just as you were called to one hope when you were called. One Lord, one faith, one baptism. One God and Father of all, who is over all, through all, and in all. Word of God. You guys made it. 25 years.
That's silver?
Silver.
Silver.
What a ride it's been. You struggled?
Like my braces.
You laughed, you cried, you turned hope. You lived together in brokenness of your deployment, and here you are rejoicing in oneness. God is good. God's called you each by name, and you're His. 25 years of living into the life worthy of God's calling. In good United Methodist fashion, you're going on to perfection. One of you is a little closer than the other, but we won't go into that. Simply means that every day you're learning to love as fully and authentically as Christ loves. The authenticity of your loves for each other shows. This Ephesians passage shows that your life is a lot of what it meant to come together as one in unity and peace, and never settling for just getting along. I think that I just hate technology.
He always has trouble.
I think I speak for everyone when I say that we all celebrate your living testimony of one body, one Spirit, as it speaks to your relationship with each other and to all others. We celebrate the passion you both have for one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Acknowledges the covenantal marriage that is irrelevant outside of a relationship with God. Your lives together acknowledge the certainty of one God and Father of all, who is above all, in all, and through all. You're dependent upon the creativity of God to bring you through your trials and temptations, which you have many, into a celebration not just in this world, but the world to come. Faith, hope, and love, these three abide. These is love. Curtis and Kelly, thank you for your love. It's our reason to celebrate, as it is yours. So, Now, you gotta look into each other's eyes. Just listen and look.
It's pretty easy to look in this.
Okay? Curtis, you get to start. Repeat after me. Okay?
Can I get a paper and pen?
I'll keep it really short. Kelly.
Kelly. You failed.
Try again.
Kelly.
There you go.
Alright. I love you more today than ever before.
I love you more today than ever before.
I'm so thankful that you are my wife.
I'm so thankful you are my wife.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I renew my marriage covenant with you.
I renew my marriage covenant with you.
To join with you and to share.
To join with you and to share.
All that is to come.
All that is to come.
To give and to receive.
To give and to receive.
To speak and to listen.
To speak and to listen.
To inspire and to respond.
To inspire and respond.
And in all our life together.
In all our life together.
Be loyal to you with my whole being.
Be loyal to you with my whole being.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Okay, Kelly, your turn. Curtis.
Curtis.
I love you more today than ever before.
I love you more today than ever before.
I'm so thankful that you're my husband.
I'm so thankful that you are my husband.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I renew my marriage covenant with you.
I renew my marriage covenant with you.
To join with you and to share.
To join with you and to share.
All that is to come.
All that is to come.
To give and to receive.
To give and to receive.
To speak and to listen.
To speak and to listen.
To inspire and to respond.
To inspire and to respond.
In all our life together.
In all our life together.
Be loyal to you with my whole being.
Be loyal to you with my whole being.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We're already married.
Curtis and Kelly, you've once again declared your vows before God, your family, and your friends. May God confirm you in the renewal of this marriage covenant and fill you both with grace. Now that they have renewed their solemn vows with the joining of hands and the kissing, I announce that they are still husband and wife.
That's the first kiss I've had since I grew my beard.
Yeah, right. That might be true.
Pretty much. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Alicia. Thank you.
Oh, it's not as romantic with the fork.
I turned just on.
This is true.